Hey everybody, it is Jason from the Texas Gun Vault 2. And I'm here tonight setting up some videos. It's kind of late at night. What is it? 9:10 on Sunday evening. And I'm going to try to get ahead on some of the Texas gun vaulting, I guess I call it, but making some videos for the week. So I thought I'd give you guys some behind the scenes of what is on tap for this week. So it's been a long weekend and I'm really kind of tired. I really should be inside resting up. Got a long week ahead of me, but I'm out here making content. So I gotta make some thumbnails. I got the camera and I'll do that, I guess, at the end. But I got a holster review from Craft Holsters. I've talked about this one before. Finally gonna get around to this one. I actually have to go inside and change because I gotta wear some jeans so I can wear my EDC belt. So I'm gonna do this holster review. I brought another holster that was made by Craft Holsters for a different gun. And what else do I got on tap? I am going to the range tomorrow with this Beretta CX4 Storm carbine. So if I'm getting shot there or in frame. So I've been showing this one off a little bit, and tomorrow's the day I get this one to the range. Then I have another range report on an AR-15, and this one is by Chi-Tac. You guys know about their rifles when it comes to long-range precision shooting. Well, I guess they now have an AR-15. And this is on loan to the channel from one of my local FFL friends. He got one in, said, do you want to review it? I said, absolutely. I got to put on some iron sights or an optic on this thing or something. Really interesting stock. Let's see what this is. It looks like a pistol buffer tube. It doesn't have any slots that you would typically see for an adjustable stock, but it has this whole mechanism in the back that can be adjusted for length of pull. And anyway, a lot of adjustments on it. Very different system. So I don't know if I'm really going to mess with this too much. It's kind of set where I think it would be typically for like an A2 length stock, which I like. So I might not mess with that, but it's different and interesting. I'm kind of curious to see how this cheek weld works because your cheek goes right up there on that buffer tube. There's no padding, and I kind of like a little bit of more padding, especially on like those SOCOM stocks. I guess I shouldn't say padding, just more bulk and mass on those. But we'll see how this thing works. It's definitely a billet lower and upper, kind of blocky. Don't know if I'm 100% on board with the aesthetics of it, but it's something different. So that's going to get reviewed tomorrow, I guess, if I go to the range, and I'll probably film the garage portion of it later this week. And I got one more thing. Oh yeah, I got a mailroom video to make. I gotta get behind the camera here real fast. Got two things. Two really interesting items. First off, I have something from one of my favorite viewers and subscribers, Craig. He sent me something. I've only opened it just to make sure the package was there and there wasn't anything like, you know, time sensitive, but something in there for me to open on the mailroom video. I'm gonna film that. It was a gift to the channel and something that was not sent as a gift to my P.O. box, but a friend gave me. And so I'm going to put it on the mailroom video. And that is a U.S. Army training grenade. Check that out. It's one of the old pineapple training grenades. So it definitely kind of, I guess, kind of fits the theme of the channel a little bit. So there it is. It's an actual real one. It has all the markings on it. It's all that, but of course it is not capable of holding explosives or anything. But this is a real training dummy grenade. So there it is. So that's pretty cool. So I am going to make a mailroom video on those two awesome items. So I will thank the people that sent me those. So that training grenade was given to me by a friend named Tom. So yeah, so there you go. And that's what's on tap for this week. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. There's a range report tomorrow. So if you're seeing this the night that I upload this, there's a range report tomorrow on a Beretta PX4 40 compact. That's what I think it is. I think it's what it is. I have to think about that. But yeah, that's what's on tap for tomorrow. So that's the Texas Gun Vault behind the scenes. I don't even know what the date is. So it's sometime in mid-June. There you go. So I got to get going. I got some thumbnails to make, some videos to make. It's a little bit hot here in the garage. And that's it. So let me know if you have any questions, and I hope you like this little behind the scenes action of the Texas Gun Vault. All right, so let me know if you have any questions. As always, thanks for watching.